deaf.
I'm not practically deaf. I can hear just fine, thank you.
Oh, yeah, what's that in your ear?
Oh, this is an idiot detector pointing straight at you.
Good one.
Whatever.
Hey, hey, where's the gavel? Who was supposed to bring the gavel? How can I calm down if you don't have a gavel? Every torp has a gavel. Oh, they're gonna laugh us right out of here like they always do.
That punk even looks like he's gonna laugh at me. How? No front teeth, I swear.
Yeah, we can use this.
You see? That's a highlighter.
We agree.
Okay, final dance.
She's there. She's scared.
Two. Get up.
Couple of hours. I'm out of here.
No, wait.
Bro, I've got a game.
You're not going anywhere. Not without this. You're locked in.
You think that's going to stop me? You don't know me very
well. Give me the key.
What?
Give me the key. You
whatever.
Hey, get her. Get her.
You're a fucking lunatic. Get your hands on me. Have you lost your mind?
Oh, God. It's like that junkie knows he's going to kill me.
You're so beautiful.
Jennifer.
What?
What are you doing?
Nothing. I just want to tell her I think he's beautiful.
This is a trial. You're not a therapy session.
You died and made you king.
He's right, Jen. Now's not the time.
I'm fine, but I still think he's beautiful.
Okay, let's get on.
What did he mean about a trial?
Wait, where's the Chucky doll?
Shut up, Tony!
Oh, shut up! Hold on! Shut up!
Tell Tony, shut up!
Did it move again? Shut up!
Great! Another break!
My name is Trenton!
Yeah! Who cares? So why are we here? Why have you morons kidnapped us? Nice nails, by the way.
You've been brought here before! The Losers Club, to be judged.
The Losers Club? Boy, that fits. This is a joke,
it's
right?
It's no joke!
You better stop laughing! This is not funny! You and Tony are on trial here! If you don't stop laughing, I'm gonna forget the trial part and go straight to the sentence.
Okay, calm down,
hey,
man.
What did you mean to be judged?
Yeah, what trial?
You're both on trial for a series of crimes committed against your fellow students.
Crimes? What crimes? I haven't committed any crimes. Do you have any idea what he's talking
not
about?
Not a clue.
It's been never stopped.
You are fat.
Hey, we're not doing it that way, Molly. You owe Tawny an apology.
Huh? What are you saying? Tawny just insulted Molly.
Bad.
We agree.
Molly?
I hate to admit it, but he's right, Molly. We're not like them.
What?
Oh. I'm sorry.
Well, I'm not.
You always don't get it, do you?
Guess what? Look, all I get is that I have been kidnapped by a bunch of losers who are going to be in serious trouble if they don't let us go. Do you have any idea what you've done?
Do you?
Would you just tell us what this is all about? Jeez.
Like we said, we all go to Clarksville High.
And every day, at least one of us is harassed by you and your friends.
Harassed? Wow, big word.
She's a genius. She knows a lot of things.
I call this court to order.
Highlight.
This court of the Losers Club has been called to order. We are here to try Joe Taylor and Tawny Harris for crimes committed against their fellow students. Is the jury ready?
We are!
Good!
Then we'll be. This is insane! I really don't have time to.
What? Shut up!
You're not finished!
Wrong answer, spot of saying. Oh god! It's the Chucky doll again!
When I was a freshman, I first saw you tearing at a football game. I thought you were the most beautiful girl I've ever seen. I used to dream what it'd be like to be you. To be the most popular girl in.
And you're telling me this because.
So one day, I decided to say hi. You were sitting with some of your friends, and I went over to say hello. I started to seduce myself when you looked at me and started laughing. Then all your friends started laughing. Soon, everybody in the hall was staring and laughing at me. I was so embarrassed. I was too ashamed to even move. When the bell rang and everyone went to class, I left school and went to the park for the rest of the day. I was counted truant, and and had to spend a couple of days in detention. But I didn't care.
Couldn't go back to school. Not that day, anyway. You made me feel like the ugliest person in the world.
I think you're big, Jen.
Yeah, right. Thanks anyway.
God, Tony, how many can you get?
But tell me! You don't even remember me, do you?
No, why should I?
Maybe you recognize my feet! Because that's what you were holding when you and your friends dunked the antifreeze in the toilet!
Come on, we're just playing around!
So you do recognize me!
No, we can get to a lot of guys.
How do you like that? I'm not even important enough to remember you and drowning me in a toilet! How would you like? How would you like to have your head in a bunch of-
I can think of better ways to spend my time!
Kevin! You're going to have-
I don't care! How's it
coming to it?
We're going to do this as planned! Everybody gets a chance to sleep!
Well, Tony put me with him! I never dumped anyone in a toilet! How disgusting!
No, your hatred is much less physical.
What are you talking about? I don't hate anyone! Well, okay, except for maybe Kimberly Morris, but she deserves it! She went out with Craig when he was supposedly in love with me! Can you believe that? I was so upset!
It really hurt!
Believe me, it did!
I never liked Kimberly either!
The only reason she's nominated for Homecoming Queen is because she went out with the entire team!
Okay, the 98% of the team. Whatever. She still escaped.
Excuse me, we're having a trial. Yeah, can we focus?
Sorry.
Where were we? There's probably not a person in this room you haven't bullied or made
I've
fun
never
of.
Made fun
Besides
of
Joe. Him.
I didn't make fun of anyone on purpose.
What? So you make fun of people on act?
No, that's not what I meant.
All I know is that ever since I got into high school, you ridiculed me every chance you got it.
I even tried to ask you a question once, and you said something like,
the elementary school's that
one. Oh, please, you shouldn't be so sensitive.
You're amazing.
Yes, I know. Look, I'm supposed to be getting with the other queen candidates in about 30 minutes.
Coach is probably going crazy wondering Ryan. He's
I remember that sophomore. I wasn't as big as I am now. I thought about trying out for cheerleader. I could jump pretty high, I could even do the splits.
I didn't think I had a chance, though.
My mom friends told me I should.
What could it hurt?
Mom said, my mom is usually right. When I got to tryouts, I was feeling pretty good.
Until I walked past you and your friends. All of you had your fingers on your nose, pushing them up like pigs. One of you even oinked as I got to the stage.
I swear it was Kara!
It doesn't matter!
All my nerves!
Bomb big time! Dude, that is so cold!
Choice to make fun of us, Joe!
What?
Choice to make fun of us free!
Yeah, Joe! Show us how you make fun of anybody not like you!
Look, I don't know what you're talking about, but if
you
I-
You know, and make sure you use the weird voice.
You're
come
crazy!
On. Show us! Do it! Say my name is Joe, and I'm a freak!
Come on, dude, give me a-
Do it! Say my name is Joe, and I'm a freak!
My name is John, I'm a freak.
Come on! Do it! Do it on your face!
You did
do it!
My name is John, I'm a freak!
Louder!
My name is John, I'm a freak!
Louder! Louder!
My name is
louder!
John,
like
say too much. Lest chance being made fun of!
Yeah, I just get tired of being called a geek all the time.
I've never called you a geek!
Sure you did, millions of times!
Well, even if I did, I mean, look how you dress!
Why should how she dresses have anything to do with the kind of person she is?
Yeah, we're not all rich, though.
You don't have to be rich to have good taste!
I'm crying out loud, Johnny!
Don't cry out loud, me, mister! I have to wear Supreme or I'm not
going. I don't wear designer stuff every day!
Oh, please, I've even heard your underwear are counting.
They're not!
Or two!
Maybe you're right, maybe we are in hell.
The point is, I'm not what I wear! None of us are!
So we like computers, and I always have a pencil in my pocket. At least, I don't carry on a protractor, or wear sandals with socks. And even if I did, so what? Who are you or anybody else to judge me? Oh, gee, I
didn't
hurt your
head,
did I?
I'm sorry. Calpurnia! Definitely not
working! Kelly, what about you? Come on, Kelly, we all promised to take part in this.
He doesn't have to do anything that they want to.
Yes, she does. We agree.
Leave her alone!
Okay, Jen, I don't really have much to say. I don't know either of you, but...
you can do it, Kelly. Come on.
We said you would. I thought I could, but I can't. I'm sorry, I just can't.
Please, Kelly, this is really important.
Can't you guys see he doesn't want to? Why not you just leave her alone?
Because this is our chance. It may be the only one we ever get.
It's really okay, Kelly. It was late May. School's nearly out. I was waiting for my mom to come and pick me up. I was standing by the gate. You know, the one by the bungalows. After a few minutes, Joe and his friends passed by. I didn't think he even noticed me, but 2 seconds later, one of her friends jumped up from behind the bungalows and scared me. He grabbed my arm and started pulling me behind the bungalows. I started to scream, but someone else put his hand over my mouth.
No way!
No, you don't
understand. It's not to understand. You don't have to finish. I said we know him right now.
Yeah. It's not like that. I didn't finish telling you what happened.
Why didn't you tell one of us, Kelly? When you told us what happened that day, you just said they scared you and someone put you down.
Why didn't you go to the police?
Good grief, Joe, you really are a creep.
It's not what you think. Joe's the one who stopped it.
What did you say?
That's what I'm trying to tell you. Joe got between me and the other boys. He told them to leave me alone or to even have to deal with him. I don't think they're going to do much. I really don't. But whatever they're going to do, Joe stopped them.
I never got to thank you, Joe. Thank you.
No. Oh, great, so now you're a hero? I hate this.
I called you a creep.
Now can they go?
One right doesn't it?
Come on, Trent, let's give it up.
Let's go.
That's right! Lucy has a right to speak!
Take it short, Lucy! We're losing steam!
When you and your friends see me in the hall, you turn around and go the other way. Or pretend to be someone else and walk past me. Like, I'm not even there. It hurts to be ignored. To feel you have some kind of disease that's contagious. You can't get CP by being around me. Or by saying hi to me.
Oh yeah! Hi, Lucy! Oh no, I caught CP!
Just like you can't go deaf by saying hi to a deaf person. Hi, Jennifer.
I'm not deaf!
I'm making a point here!
Okay. Hi, Lucy.
Oh no, what did you say? I can't hear. I must be deaf.
What's so funny?
And what's so funny?
You don't have the right to laugh. You're not one of us.
Alright, alright!
Anybody else?
I need to say this. Because I'm gay, I get picked on a lot. And I'm not welcome in a lot of places. I don't feel welcome at school most of the time.
I'm not welcome in a lot of people's homes.
But it hurt the most when I wasn't welcome on the basketball court.
The other girls refused to play with me.
You get it, you're a jock, right? I love basketball more than anything. I was told many times that I could have gotten a college basketball scholarship. You see, I don't come from a rich family. A scholarship could have changed my life. When I look at the stats board in the school showcase, I know my name should be up there, just like yours. I was robbed. Anytime someone is the least bit different, you make sure you put them down.
But those put downs have more of an effect than you can ever know.
Yeah.
I was a cutter, and once I tried to kill myself.
What?
Yeah.
After that, my parents and my therapist asked me if I wanted to change schools.
They were desperate. I told them no. If I leave, they win. Just when I was at my lowest.
I met Kev and all of you.
You guys gave me a school family that I could go to. You guys gave me hope that I could be accepted for who I am.
And that just maybe, I am good enough.
That's right.
Okay.
nothing but whiners.
Poor, pitiful me. Everybody picks on me. Well, well, well. Get over it! If you don't like how you're treated, tell something about it. Stand up for yourself. And if you don't like how you look, change it. But for goodness sake, stop whining.
Boy, you guys better hope I win tonight.
Nice, Tony.
Well, well, what, Kevin? What do you suggest we do?
Huh? What? I don't know, but we just can't leave them here. After all this.
Easy, Kevin, go.
This sucks. Go ahead,
leave. What are we going
to
do?
It's not just me. It's each of us. What do you suggest we do? Tie them up and leave them for a few days? Torture them? Hang them? Why?
Don't yell at Lucy.
Yeah, you're the one who came up with this whole trial thing anyway. You didn't have to agree.
I did.
Why did you call him
that? Shut up, Tony.
Did you hear that? He told me to shut up. You can't tell him to shut up.
I think I'm going to get shut up.
No, I didn't tell him. God, wait. Kevin, you're me.
Here's an idea. Why don't you both shut up?
According to you, I'm practically dead. Remember? So, if I could set up, how would I know I'm set up? If I can't hear myself, duck out!
What? How could it be so stupid?
You come up with any brilliant ideas?
We can't just go home. We don't just go home. We don't gotta jump and down.
Funny in our bed? Listen to yourself.
Yeah, so what's your point?
My point is that I know I've done my share of making fun of you. But Tony's right. If you don't like how you're being treated, do something about it. And for God's sakes, tell somebody. Look, I've seen you guys around for a long time. Everybody has. We may not know your names, but we always see you together. Always sticking up for each other. Supporting each other. You're friends. True friends. Hey, you think Tony and I are really friends? No.
What?
They may never admit it. But a lot of people envy
us. Yeah, right. People envy us? I don't think so.
Any best friends I've ever had.
Me three.
Okay, we get the point. We're friends.
Well, this has been so much fun, but unlike you losers, I actually have some place to be. You know, I can report this little incident to the administration.
What?
Not to mention the police.
Oh,
and maybe I will. I haven't decided yet. Just pray I'm Queen Tani by the end of the night. Loser!
For a minute there, I thought you might actually be human.
See ya, never.
Tani?
What?
Just in case you do plan on telling anyone about tonight, well, I know how hard it would be for you to turn in your boyfriend.
Oh, what are you talking about? We're not dating.
I'm not talking about me. So you turn in my man.
What?
I can't help it. I mean, I just didn't believe you and Tani were me.
That's the most disgusting thing I've ever heard!
Harris, wow!
For sure, you thought you wouldn't tell anybody.
Dang, Tony, Harris!
Looks like our little secret's out.
Don't call me, honey! It's inside! You and that there is no secret!
Baby.
Remember when we used to paint each other's toenails black and put black lipstick on each other?
I'm gonna be sick!
I'm sorry about this, Tom. I wanted to keep it a secret, but when I saw the most popular girl in school with such a loser like Trennan, no offense.
I'm taking
this. Well, I just had to know what was going on. So I started to ask Kimberly.
You didn't! You what?
I didn't, but I could, and I will. Unless, of course, you don't want.
Are you crazy? Of course I don't want you! Wait, what am I saying? None of this is true!
Tony, precious, how can you continue to-
Get away from me!
Our word against yours, and I am the captain of the football team. Hey, I have an idea. Jenny, why don't you escort your girlfriend to the football game in front of the whole school to see?
Yeah!
As a matter of fact, why doesn't everyone escort Tony to the field?
Yeah! Don't you dare! Don't anybody move, or I swear I'll-
What?
Oh, what? Oh, please! I don't do this! I'll never make fun of any of you again! I promise! You don't exist! None of you! This night never happened! Just please let me go alone!
We won't tell if you won't tell.
I promise! I promise!
Tony! Anytime you want to go out again!
You just poke with those beautiful lips and tongue.
You can see your face!
I thought you'd barf right then and there.
Did you really go out with her?
Calpurnia, I would go out with Tony if you want to talk to Tony Harris. Thanks!
No problem.
So what a big change!
Being in a room for an hour with Tony Harris would change anybody. Besides, after everything has been said and done tonight, I figured I know what you guys want. Better get going. Football game. Man, is the coach going to be ticked?
What will you tell him?
The truth? That I was kidnapped and taken to an abandoned classroom was put on trial by members of the Losers Club, whose leader is a guy who wears black fingernail polish. Then, when he stops laughing, I'll tell him something he'll believe. I'll make sure my friends leave you alone from now on.
Thanks! But we don't need your protection, just your respect.
Yeah. You're calling yourself the Losers Club. Why do you even call yourself that?
Because of being a winner, we turning people and putting them down on time
we'd rather be called losers anyway.
Well, yeah, right. Then I guess you need to make up your own definition of what a winner is. I'm out.
No matter what!
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 Kevin!
Fine. No matter what. Let's get out of here.
I love you guys.